Good afternoon. I'm Mohamed Elati, and I work for ISSB, the Institute of Systems and Synthetic Biology in Paris. First of all, I would like to thank the organizer for giving me the opportunity to present our cytoscape application called PEPPER. So this application was designed for protein complex expansions using protein-protein interaction network. Let me start by the biological question. How can we identify protein complexes from a single proteomic studies? For example, we're working with Radvani lab, who is interested in characterizing the FGFR3 pathway that stimulates cell proliferation in bladder cancer. So in order to characterize this pathway, they use a technique called affinity purification followed by mass spectrometry. This technique pulled down used a protein as a bait, here FGFR3, together with interaction partners. So the output of MS pull-down data is a list of proteins and can be interpreted as a protein complex in at least two ways. In the spoke model, proteins are only connected with the bait, and in matrix model, proteins are fully connected. Although Bader and Og demonstrated that the spoke model is roughly 3 times more accurate than the matrix model, the actual complex is different from both models. Because there is no model for protein complex interactions, and APMS experiments capture non-specific protein interaction, like 8-4, and miscore ones, like here, false negative. So our goal, therefore, is to predict the topology of protein complex. In order to accomplish this, we thought to include protein interaction networks from databases like BioGrid. However, when we connected FGFR3 with protein-protein interaction network from BioGrid, we find a poorly connected subnetwork. On the other hand, if we just add the first neighbor of FGFR3 partners, we find herbal diagram. So to avoid getting this network, we need to develop novel graph algorithm. So we formulated this problem as given a graph G and a list of seed vertices L, find subgraph that maximize two objectives. The first objective is the maximization of the subgraph topological density, computed as the ratio between the number of the edges in the graph and all possible edges. The second objective aim to find what we call coverage. I aim to include as many seed proteins as possible in the graph. In practice, the coverage will be the value of the coverage will be high if we have a big subgraph, but usually the density, the other objective, will be low. And vice versa, if we have small subgraph, the density, the topological density of the graph can be high, but the coverage will be low. So these two objectives conflict each other, and there is no solution that dominate, that can be considered to dominate all other solutions. This is a typical multi-objective problem. We solve this multi-objective optimization problem using a redesigned version of the strength Pareto evolutionary algorithm, SPA2. This is a popular approach in the field of multi-objective optimization. And here the SPA2 was modified so that it will be able to handle network instead of real values. So the output of this step will be a non-dominated set of subnetwork that will be merged into a final subnetwork in the second step by maximizing the modularity with a greedy search algorithm. So this step will help to remove a high connected protein that are not specific to the complex, typically the hub in the protein-protein interaction network. We assess the performance of PEPPER on a set of single APMS experiments from yeast and human that match hand-curated protein complexes as gold standard. We compare with two popular approaches for protein complex discovery, MCOD and cluster one. The output of these two algorithms is a set of cluster. So here we select for each experimenter the cluster that match better the original list. Overall, we have better performance in all measure of performance, and in average, we have an increase of accuracy of 12% in yeast and 16% in human. Motivated by these good results, we developed PEPPER as a cytoscape application. The input of the application is a seed proteins and a PPI network. The core of cytoscape involves three main steps. The two first steps for the subgraph extraction, and we include a third step for post-processing. The post-processing analysis computes a score, use the graph topology and known complex matching and functional annotation. Then PEPPER uses this score to rank expansions and to facilitate visualization and interpretation of the predicted complexes. So in this slide, I just show to you how the user interface of PEPPER look in cytoscape. In this example, PEPPER expanded a list of protein highlighted in green circle by adding three proteins highlighted in red. And overall, we can see that PEPPER improved greatly the topological density of the complex. Thanks to the open source platform of cytoscape, we can consider PEPPER as all-in-one tools for predicting protein complex membership by combining experimental results from a single MS pull-down data and existing protein-protein interaction network, and integrate post-processing feature to link the results to existing complexes and annotations. In the end, I would like to invite you to visit and download our application in the cytoscape app store, as well as to read our paper published recently in as application note in bioinformatics. To finish, I would like to thank my students, Charles and Rémi Nichols. This is a joint work, and François Radvani. This is the biologist that we work with, in particular to characterize the FGFR pathway. And thank you for your attention.